Hey guys, another video from paradise. However, my mood is not in paradise. So yeah, altcoins got hit very strongly, Bitcoin much less, but total market cap now is 80 billion. We were at 110 billion, but what's weird is my portfolio, really, my altcoins in Frank's portfolio have dropped a lot, and also like it's almost divided by two in fiat value in only a month's time or so, or a couple of weeks from the high. It's still times 10 from the low, so can't complain just yet, but it's really shocking how big of a hit that got. And the other coins, Bitball is still okay, but Zcash totally collapsed as well. Well, luckily I didn't do too many stupid moves, although I was close to buying some more, actually, only a few weeks ago. Luckily I didn't do that. I sold some of Frank's portfolio last week and invested in just Bitcoin. So I did the right moves, but not nearly enough. Of course, I made a video last week where I discovered that actually cryptos are not valued that high compared to past valuations. So that's what kept me from selling. I was very close to selling a lot there, but I didn't do it. So, and now the market dropped, but actually it didn't drop that much just yet. My portfolio did, but in general, the cryptocurrency market is still at 80 billion. When I made the video, altcoins in paradise, you know what the total market cap was? 30 billion. And we were already, I was already euphoric. It went times four from there to 120 billion. And now it's at 80. But I do still think it looks more and more that the bear market has started, and that means that the high was under 20 billion, and it's pretty certain it's gonna collapse by 80% on average. So that means that the low will be 25 billion. So we're still at 80, so still a ways to go, and this can all go very fast. Or it can take many months, or it can take happen in only a week. That's uncertain. It's most likely actually it will take many months, and then after the low is found, it will go up again. But it can go pretty. It can all go pretty fast too. It's very hard to tell. But for me, it really impacts me losing money. It's hard on me, and even though I made very good money in this bull market, I'm still quite heavily exposed, and so from the high, my portfolio is now down minus 25%, and my crypto portfolio is down minus 50%. So that starts to count. And I have a very hard time not to panic sell. I really have a very hard time with that. I'm here in paradise, and all what's in my mind is this market collapsing. I could do so much fun things, but that's totally dominating me. So for me, investing is a quite it's a hard job. And it feels tremendous when I make money, but it really feels horrible when I lose money too. So I hope that in the future I can become more of an entrepreneur, or the kind of investor that's able to just like keep his mind relaxed and is able to sit through all these bulls and bears and enjoy life. But it's not for me. I think I could do that probably much better if I would be like the boss of a project. If I would be a real entrepreneur, like I built a coin or I built a company, then if the value of my company goes down, the stock or my coin goes down, it's not that important, because because you're busy working on building the coin or the company, and you know it's going to be all right later, and so you have strong hands. But for me as an investor, I look at all these coins that I invest myself in also, and I see so many weaknesses, things that I would do differently, and I can imagine perfectly for all these projects to fail, even though I have found them to be the best projects. So I have much less confidence in others than in myself, and maybe that's a weakness of me as an investor. It's not a happy video, even though my portfolio is still up a lot. So I think I'm also a little bit out of touch. It's weird how that goes, but when prices go down, even though you're still up a lot, you don't want to sell because it was higher before, and you feel you're selling at a loss. But that's not really true, because you're still at a great profit, even though it went down, and the market can go a lot lower, so it still makes sense to sell. But it's also, I have to admit that I didn't sell enough in the past then. If I have to sell today, my asset allocation strategy, I should have gone to a majority fiat, not once, but again. When the portfolio crypto was up again, and crypto was up again, the majority, I should have again cut back strongly, but I didn't do it, and now I'm paying the price for that. And if I would have done that, I would have felt much better today. So it's always like, yeah, it's difficult. I'm thinking what else I can say. Show you the beautiful beach, huh? So yeah, it's you always have to think both ways. How will I feel if the market goes up a lot from here, about my actions, and then I can't really like do much today. I can sell some things, I can sell some bite ball that's not down too much, but for the rest I can't sell much because it's been going down already a lot. And well, even though the bear has started, even when the bear has started, it can still rebound strongly. But of course, we're not down that much. But we basically went down straight from the high of 120 million to now 120 billion to now 80 billion. So that's minus 30%, 35%. So it could go back up to 100 billion, but it could also go straight to 60 or 50 billion. And then the rebound will be not 100 billion, it will be 65 billion at the rebound. So that's possible too. That's why I'm thinking, yeah, I should probably sell some today. Sorry, it's not a happy video, guys. Peace out.